Welcome back to consecutive day 843 of A Diary of a Runpreneur. Please give this a subscribe and a share as it's part of a fundraiser to save the lives of children by attempting the ultimate ultra marathon. All the information is in the link in the comments below. Thank you for your support as always, and let's get started. So, consecutive day 843 of A Diary of a Runpreneur, and yeah, running again today. It's now Wednesday, and I finished my 70k ultra, 24-hour ultra marathon on Sunday. So I've had half of Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and this is the third day. So I've done two runs since the ultra, and this is my third run. And it's definitely easier. It's not as painful as the previous 2 days, but I'm still severely run down. Mainly from an energy perspective. I think my legs and muscles are recovering quite nicely. Tight calves are still a little bit tight. Quads, hamstrings seem to be back to normal. But breathing, energy, heart rate is all working extra hard, and it just makes these runs slower and harder. So I should hopefully be back to more normality in the next couple of days. But it just goes to show how long your body takes to recover after putting it through such a demanding, rigorous workout. And I'll go back to my first ever marathon, London Marathon, I think 2017, was it maybe? 2018 maybe? I can't remember, but it was a good few years back now. And it was the hottest marathon on record. And I hit the wall in that marathon. It was probably one of the most unenjoyable experiences of my life, because my body was basically dying as I crossed the finish line and collapsed and had to get taken to the medical tent to be revitalised, should I say, back to some kind of normal functioning state, of which I was then felt sick for the next couple of days. But yeah, take me back to that event, and obviously I hadn't fueled correctly, but it took me a good, at least a full week, maybe 2 weeks, to even remotely feel back to normal. So recovery is really, really important. I'm pretty well versed at recovering quickly on the basis that I'm on 843 day running streak. My body's used to churning this out, and actually I find these slow recovery runs aid my recovery, but still hard work, and I can only speed it up so much that I still have to let my body run its course. So anyway, next thing I wanted to talk about was business. And this week, it's a short week because it's been bank holiday Monday due to Queen Elizabeth II's funeral on Monday. So we had a public holiday, which was unexpected, which was nice. But then on Friday, I've only got a half day because I fly to Ireland for a family wedding, which is cool. But this week, we're trying to launch our new program for our partners to join forces with us as a business, so we can really leverage the people power of our sourcing and investor securing networks. And we've kind of built this kind of structured program to train people on the systems and processes, how we operate, and to give them a roadmap to get to £10,000 a month within a year. You know, and we'd like to think that that's for aggressively attacking this process. For people who do it slightly slower, maybe 2 years is the plan. But it's very, very achievable, very, very attainable. And we've had nearly 1,000 applicants for this. So we will be launching on Friday. And we're just getting together all the resources, video instructions together, all these types of things to get people ready to be set up effectively. And it could be a real milestone in the business, as leverages, it obviously can work against you. But if you get leverage right, it can exponentially drive the growth of your business to the next level, or 10 levels above. So at the moment we've got, I think, 6 people that are partners with us at the moment. We've got 1,000 applicants, so say we get 5% of them who turn out to be any good. That's going to be another 50 people. So that's 10xing our labour resource, which, if they turn out to be as good as our existing team, will 10x our sourcing and securing investment networks, which is super, super exciting. So yeah, watch this space. But as a result, I'm just really drained mentally as well with the focus and effort on getting everything ready for this launch on Friday. Now we will be there, but it is a hard slog. So I'll keep you posted on this because it's really quite exciting. And I think the problem that I faced, I've had conversations with my business partner Jack, that with these types of launches, you want to plan and map them out in a timely fashion to not put too much stress and burden on your team that have to work together to create something as big as an online course, which is going to onboard people into our business ecosystem, if you like. And I had a long conversation with Jack, and we were disagreeing, but then we came to an agreement, because I know how long these things take. He doesn't. He likes to put dates and things out there without realizing the full extent of what needs to go into the back office, and then we'll be quick to moan when things aren't perfect at launch without understanding that. But then at the same time, in this scenario, because we always say we try and learn from previous experiences, in this example, he put some posts out for his content. Now, he's amazing at social media, sales, marketing, driving interest, driving traffic, engaging people. And he put some content out, which was part of his kind of content plan. And this one post about his thought process of, because this is his kind of idea. Most of the ideas are Jack's. I'm more the person who can strategize, put the infrastructure, business, build a business around the ideas. And this was his idea to bring all these people in. I wasn't necessarily for it, to be honest with you. But when he put a post out there and we had some 800 odd comments, you have to take notice to content like that gets that much engagement. There is an underlying message there, and the message was that these people were seriously interested in this model, and we need to act now so that the impact hasn't diluted, which is why ultimately we've pushed ourselves to launch relatively quickly. So yeah, the moral to the story today, I try and do a moral to the story each day, is two morals to the story today. One, never underestimate your recovery from an endurance event, and make sure you take the right precautions to ensure you avoid injury. And number two moral to the story is, planning is great, but sometimes in life something happens where it sends a message is sent to you, and you have to act pretty quickly to capitalize on the opportunity that's presented. Not always, but in certain circumstances. And this, I believe, is that circumstance. If we were planning a launch of a new product, very different. We would do it in a more strategic process, and we would put have beta plans, beta programs, minimum viable products, processes in place well in advance of an actual official launch. But in this, it was a bit of content which just went completely viral, and we needed to capitalize on it. So anyway, waffling over, that's it for me today. Any comments, drop me a line, I'll respond to everyone. Please do give us a subscribe and a share as a part of a fundraiser to save the lives of children by attempting the ultimate ultramarathon. All the information is in the link in the comments below. Thank you for your support. As always, stay positive, stay happy, and I'll see you again tomorrow.